Jerry Jones, while you're concerned with silencing your black players, you should be concerned with fixing that atrocious defense that you have on the field right now. Now, I know you have a business to run, but to build your reputation as well as your wealth in the National Football League off the backs of so many African-American players, and then to turn around and shun their attempt to raise awareness to very real problems going on in the communities from which they come from, is dead wrong. Now, I can tell you, I've been a Dallas Cowboy fan since 1991, and it's not an easy thing being a Dallas Cowboy fan. Over the past 20 years, there's been a whole lot of disappointment, a whole lot of frustration. As a Cowboys fan, you have to deal with a lot of hatred. I've lost bets, put my money where my mouth is. I've lost my voice arguing and defending the honor of the Cowboys and their star. But I can tell you right now, I'm done. But before I leave, there's a few things I want to get off my chest. First off, you haven't done anything right since you hired Jimmy Johnson. Secondly, your desire to control every single thing is the reason why the Cowboys fell off, and it's been 20 plus years we've been trying to climb back up the mountain. It's all your fault. And you know why you don't have a home field advantage, Jerry Jones? It's because your games cost too damn much. The everyday, hardcore, blue-collar Dallas Cowboy fan can't afford to come to the games and pay $75 to park and pay $20 for a hot dog, all on top of the admission costs. It costs too much, especially for that mediocre product that's been out there on the field the past 20 years. And yeah, that stunt that you pulled a few weeks back, you know, where you pretended to be concerned with the issues going on with the players in this protest, and you linked arms and took a knee, you did that to show up the president. And then you turn around and issue a threat to your own team and tell them that if they do the same thing and show you up, that you're going to sit them or possibly get rid of them. That will make you a damn hypocrite. I wish I was on your team, Jerry. I would kneel. The same reason that you kneeled, I would kneel, plus the reasons that Colin Kaepernick and the rest of the players protesting are kneeling. The injustice, the inequality, and police brutality. Three very real wrongs and three very real problems in our society. You know what? If you were really a truly honorable leader, what you would have done was sit down with your overwhelmingly black team and discuss ways to support and help raise awareness to these issues and team up with those players. At the end of the day, you chose to ostracize and punish. And that's the reason why the protests have continued to build steam. See, if you were truly a leader, you'd have tried to find a way to bring the players together and bring your team together. At the end of the day, the NFL has a social awareness program, a social responsibility program, And that social responsibility program is already raising awareness to breast cancer. It's already fighting domestic abuse, domestic violence, as well as child abuse. You already have a social program fighting wrongs in society. If you were a leader, you would have sat with these players, find out what they're protesting about, and added those things to the program that's already existing. But no, you'd rather crack your whip and act like a slave owner. So you know what? I can't respect that. I can't respect you. And I'm done with the Dallas Cowboys. I am no longer supporting the Dallas Cowboys because I no longer support Jerry Jones. And I have a ton of paraphernalia that I'm getting rid of. So if you want some Cowboy stuff, holler at me.